Good morning, everybody. Welcome to the show. You listen to Hammer Radio Network at Hammer 96.7. Number one show in the morning on Blog Talk Radio. I am Brian the Hammer Jackson. Today we have a very special guest. Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening. We are global. We're heard worldwide. And if you'd like to come in the studio today, you know the number. I'll give it to you later because I don't have it. There you go. All you have to do is look at the marquee and come on in. Today I have one of my dearest friends, Morali. Morali is here today. He's a good friend. He's spiritual. As far as I'm concerned, he's a spiritual genius. He reflects on some of the moments that we have changed our lives forever, changed his. And he reflects on some of the history and some of the men in the history. I just took an excerpt of it. We call this, and he calls this, the greatest statesman of all time of the entire world in my 70 years of life. One little snippet I took out of here was Berlin and Hitler to Russia. It was a big slap in the face of the USA and is a black spot on the way Eisenhower fought the war. And today we're going to talk to Mr. Morali. The greatest statesman of all time is brilliant. Join us today. Learn some knowledge in history, and as far as I'm concerned, Morali is a big genius. He's really, really smart. And without further ado, let me introduce Mr. Morali. He's in the studio today, and you're more than welcome to come to the studio. Here we go. Good morning, sir. How are you, Mr. Morali?
Good morning, Brian. I'm here very nice, and I thank you very much for having me one more time in your studio and give me an opportunity to tell my views to the world. Thank you very much. I'm doing well, and thank you.
You're welcome. You're always welcome to the studio. You know that. Would you call what I read, I know you call it the greatest statement of all time, would you call it a manifesto, or would you call it a manuscript, or what would you call it, a document?
It's a document, Bob. You know, I had been contemplating on this aspect for quite some time. You know, sometime in the last century, towards the end, they wanted people to vote for the greatest person of the 20th century, and people were voting Winston Churchill and Mahatma Gandhi, and Martin Luther King, with Nelson Mandela, and so on and so forth. But nowhere was the name of Harry Truman found. I felt bad. What is this? People are not recognizing. People have become blind or what? Why are they not seeing? And so I had been jotting my thoughts about him and some of the historical facts. And finally I prepared a document sometime back, and it was with me, you know. Publishing it is not easy. New York Times or Washington Post, they don't entertain guys like me.
Okay.
So I kept it with me, and finally I shared with you, which you felt should be known to the world. And here we are. It's just a document, but I think it should be documented well, and it should it has the merit to appear in bigger magazines, like bigger papers like New York Times or the Washington Post or whatever. And it should be known to at least to Americans, because American, he's an American. He's a true blue American.
Mm-hmm.
And all the values that America espouses today are inculcated or brought in by Harry Truman. And most people do not know.
Well, tell me about Harry. Well, before we go to Harry Truman, again, I consider you a genius, and I also consider you one of my good friends. Would you let everybody know about your background, Morali, because it's just remarkable. I know you've been on the show before, but we have a larger new audience, and tell them a little bit about yourself, and then we'll go right into your document. Because I think the document is brilliant, by the way.
Sure, Brian. You know, I'm a lower middle class boy who studied in a small village in the interior India way back in 1950s, 60s. And I studied my entire school in my mother tongue, Telugu language medium. Then I started working. And I was working initially in manufacturing. And then I migrated to computers and software. It was an accident, not really planned, but it was an accident. And because the Y2K had come into India, and we had a lot of opportunity to help America to overcome that problem. And Bill Clinton, his genius, really, and our Prime Minister, Mr. Narasimha Rao, will ensure what Gartner has estimated at an expense of $600 billion to convert the computer systems to be Y2K compliant. I think he did not spend more than $5-6 billion by outsourcing it to America and saved that much money. And when America woke up on the 1st of January 2000, nothing changed. People started calling it was a hoax and all, but the genius of Clinton, Bill Clinton, whatever may be his other shortcomings, but in this, he saved America. And we got an opportunity. I came to computers, and having worked for some time, then I began my own consulting in 2001. And I've been my freelance consultant from that time onwards. I started writing books in 2006-07, and I completed about 15 books by now. And with recently, I've been translating Sanskrit epics into English, because they have they're great books, and unless they are in English, the world cannot read them. Sanskrit is more or less a dead language. That means no population is speaking it as their mother tongue. It is there and people know it, but like Latin, nobody speaks it. So I'm translating some books. So far I've translated 4 books into English. And besides that, you know, I've been writing essays, 3-page, 2-page articles, and some are published, some are not published. On the site of Stellar House Publishing, my 6-7 articles are there. They're very well read by the Americans and all the world. Each article attracted more than 100,000 reads. And I'm doing that. I'm a thinker. And some people call me thought leader, to friends like you. Others call me a maverick. I prefer the title maverick. So that is about me, Brian.
Well, you know what?
I have two sons who are in America. And that's how I shifted to America in 2018.
You know, I was reading, something caught my eye, and again, we're talking to the great Morali, the greatest statesman of all time, of the entire world, and his you mentioned 70 years of life. I think you're younger, but we'll go with that. You read about some personalities here, and this caught my eye. You say, I have read about many personalities. Some were historic, meaning that they lived and died even before I was born. Some were of recent origin, and some were of ancient origin. The existence of some was questioned, and some are accepted to have existed. Here's what caught my eye. Some were thought to be incarnations of God, or were sent by God to uplift human beings. I consider all of them, and then here you say, I consider all of them, but the man that stands out as having affected the most positive impact on humanity, in your humble opinion, is Harrison Shipp, Solomon, and Truman. Now, are you saying that these men are more, they have changed more people's lives or impacted the human beings more than, when you say some were sent by God, I'm thinking Jesus. So would you say that these people have put more impact in Jesus? When you talk about Harrison Shipp and Solomon and Truman, they impacted people's more life than you think Jesus Christ did?
But Bob, Shipp, Solomon, Ship and Solomon are the names of the grandfathers of Truman. So their parents wanted to ask her both, and just they fixed a middle initial S without making it a full name. So it is basically Harrison S. Truman. And if you ask me whether Truman impacted lives more positively than either Jesus Christ or Prophet Muhammad or Lord Krishna, I dare say, and maybe people may differ with me, most people may differ with me, Harry Truman impacted more positively than either Jesus Christ, Prophet Muhammad or Lord Krishna or Buddha put together. They did not impact so many people in their time. Their teachings were taken by their apostles, disciples or descendants or somebody, and they propagated their ideas perhaps, or some of it has been added in by the latter people. But Truman, in his own lifetime, in a short span of about 7 years, he brought in so much impact without impacting their roots. I think it is simply, unimaginable. If I can do 1/10 of what Truman did in his life, in his 7 years, I'll be very grateful to God for giving me this. I think Truman impacted more positively than all those people. People may disagree with me, but I strongly feel that Truman has been really phenomenal, remarkable.
If he did not drop the bomb in Japan, would he be as memorable or as great in your mind as he is? Would he be as a legend in your mind? And the life he led, if he did not drop that bomb, if he was just being a regular guy in his character and being the president of the United States, would he be just as legendary? Or that when he dropped that bomb, he became more of a legend, in your opinion, in Japan?
In Japan, they may still castigate Truman as a villain, but the world, he is a legend. Because in the last 75 years since that day, since 1945-2020, that is 55 plus 20, 75 years, no other world leader could take a decision to drop a bomb, even though there are 20 countries who have the atom bomb. He had the moral right when he said, in the movie they depicted the scene very well. His political Democratic Party, some person comes and tells him, Truman, you drop this bomb and our party and your presidency will be castigated eternally. So don't do that. It is disadvantageous for the Democratic Party. And it turns out that way because next election was won by Republican Party Eisenhower. Truman answered him in the movie. I don't know what exactly. If American people come to know that I can avoid complete American loss of American life, I have the weapon to stop further loss of American life, and I did not use it because my party is going to lose, will the American people pardon me? That is the moral. He said, I will stop further loss of human life with this one loss. I am putting a stop to the world war. And he did that. Even though his popularity was low, the next president refused to have tea with him. His party lost. And he stepped down with the lowest popularity rating. He did it and stopped the war. And the second, third world war did not come for 75 years because of that one action. He is the man with guts. As perhaps you Americans say, he is the man with the balls. No, who else had that kind of courage and bravery? Sorry for saying that word.
No. You're right. Accurate. He had some big ass balls to do that.
Yes.
In your opinion, when NATO was created, did it change the world? In your opinion. How important is the North Atlantic Treaty Agreement or organization?
North Atlantic Treaty Organization, he created that organization to counter the influence, growing influence of USSR, United States of Soviet Socialist Republics, and the personal ambitions of Joseph Stalin, who was trying to create another empire. Second World War demolished the empires of European powers like UK, Great Britain, France, and Italy. And silently he built the Soviet Empire, Russian Empire. He occupied almost all the East European countries. And the Soviet Empire lasted for 40, 50 years until 1990 when Gorbachev came. And after the Gorbachev, the Soviet Empire demolished. But he was building it. He has to counter that. Without countering that, Germany and certainly France all would have come under the yoke of USSR. It stopped the expansion of Soviet Empire into further into Europe, and it has served its purpose until 1990s. NATO was the one that was the deterrent for the Soviet Union to expand further. Even then, even after NATO, Soviet Russia under Brezhnev occupied Czech Republic and Afghanistan. They further expanded, and only the deterrent of NATO could halt that. So NATO was very powerful. Without NATO, UNO could not have done it, because UNO Security Council, USSR has a veto. So they can veto any action against Russia, but NATO he cannot. So it was a great organization. It has not only that, the NATO and CETO in the Southeast Asian organization, treaty organization, that also saved the Southeast Asia from Soviet expansion through China. So it was a great organization, and he did that. It is because of him.
So, you know, yeah, Harry Truman. Of course, do you have the picture of the newspaper Dewey Wins when he was running against Dewey? I mean, the famous thing. When he
they defeat Truman.
right. I didn't know that he created the United Nations organization. I had no idea Harry Truman. I mean, I should be ashamed of myself because I didn't know that history, that he created the United Nations organization. I should be ashamed. Maybe I fell asleep in class that day. I should be ashamed of myself. you credit him with the creation of Israel. Is that true?
Yes. Yes,
can you,
Bob. You know, yes, definitely. You know, Israel. Where was Israel before the Second World War? There was no Israel, and the whole territory, not even Palestine, the whole territory was Middle East. Controlled by Great Britain. Great Britain called itself the protectorate, but actually it was the ruler. And there were no borders drawn there. Iraq, Iran, there were no countries like Iran, Iraq. It was Arab, that's all. And when the Second World War has ended, and the Jews' Holocaust has come onto the stage with the military and the journalists taking photographs and publishing all over the world, he said, you know, he had called all the rich Jews in the America, bankers and Hollywood studio owners, and tell them, let us do something. And they all financed the sending of Jews from Europe to Israel. How could those Jews go from Europe to Israel without any financial backing? Where did they get the boats? And they bought the land, entire Israel. People do not know, and they talk loosely, the whole entire Israeli land, which is under Israel, in 1948 was purchased with American money by Jews there. They pumped in money and they bought the land. Once all the land was bought, they said, please give us the country. And that who backed that petition in the United Nations? Did Russia back it up? Did Great Britain back it up? America backed it up. America backed it up because of Truman. Truman backed it up. Truman was silent. He did not take any credit. A man like Truman, as a boon to USA and the world, the God himself sent him to this earth so that he can take all these actions. And he has moved the resolution in United Nations Organization, Security Council. That was the only occasion when Russia and United States and Union of Soviet Socialist Republics voted for the same party, creation of Israel. And that is how he created Israel. Without him, there was no Israel. Who backed them up? Because their hunger strikes, the hunger strikes were very minimal. They had military power, nothing. And the moment in 1948, Israel was created, the next day, all the Arab nations with the British and French arms invaded Israel. Who fought for the independence of Israel? Did Israel create an army by that time? It was American army that fought the Arab forces and drove them away. And continuously sustained, he sustained it until 52 and ensured that Israel has a place in the world map and created it. The entire world Jews must be thankful to Truman for his creation of Israel. Without him, there was no Israel.
And you should also, in your piece, the Germans should be thankful for Truman and bless him before their meals?
Definitely, Brian. You know,
yes.
Germany, after the First World War, they were made to sign a treaty which was very disadvantageous for them. And
right.
They were humiliated. And because of that humiliation, Hitler rose and fought the Second World War. But after Second World War, Truman brought in the doctrine of reconstruction. Earlier, the country that was vanquished, they were paying reparations, whereas the victor here paid reparations. He reconstructed entire Europe, Great Britain, Germany. Germany was pulverized to the ground. There was nothing left there. He went and built all the things. He called it Marshall Plan. He did not take any credit. But Marshall Plan was backed up by Truman, and Truman appointed Marshall to do that over the head of Eisenhower, and he created that, he reconstructed that. He created West Berlin such that West Berlin has in its constitution that all the East Germans are their citizens, so they can anytime migrate. And he created a free society in Germany, so that at a future point of time, they can reunite. And Germany lived with their head held high. They were never, he made sure that Hitler or Germans were never criticized. You know, when Germans did not stand behind Hitler, he could not have done that. Germans stood behind Hitler in the Holocaust of Jews or in the fighting of the war. They fought sincerely. But he has separated. Hitler did everything, not Germans. So let us not treat Germans as villains, and he ensured that in the time that he was there. And by the time he left, Germans were accepted as the proud members of the international community, and he gave them new infrastructure, he gave them a lot of money, he bought a lot of things from Germany, and he made Germany stand again on its legs. And he was the he planted the seed, and in its infancy watered it. And he ensured that its growth and that it will continue to grow. If today Germany is united and standing on its own legs, it was protected. Germany was also protected with his army. The American army was stationed in Germany until very recently. And he started that. He protected Germany. He protected everyone. And that's how Germany is free today. And Germans are able to say, hold their head high in spite of doing so many atrocities during the Second World War and the period before 1945 because of Truman. If they don't bless him, then they're before taking meals, thank God, they bless Truman and take care of him. You know, they are unfair. They are not doing their duty. Israel and Germany both will have to thank Truman. Even Indians, in East India. We got independence because of Truman. I think of him every day.
He's an inspiration. And like you said, big balls. I did not know this, and I hope I'm reading it right, and please correct me if I'm doing it wrong. Was Truman the one who limited the presidency of the USA to 2 terms? I mean, before that?
Yes.
How many terms could a president? I know that I'm trying to think of how many terms George Washington. I thought George Washington had 2 terms. So I didn't know. So help me with that. What part did Truman play with the terms that a president can serve his country?
You know, Franklin Delano Roosevelt, the predecessor to Truman, he was elected mm-hmm. 4 times.
Oh.
Continuously. Continuously, 4 terms. And he would have contested once more had he lived. And then Truman felt that, you know, the president should not continuously be the same person. It leads to dictatorship. And he got the legislation passed in the House and then signed it. In that legislation, they have put in a clause that the present president is exempt from this law.
Mm.
And he vetoed it. He said, no, change it. Even I'm included in it. He could have vetoed that. He had the power to veto, but he said, include me also. No future president shall contest shall be a president for a 3rd term, only 2 terms. It needs an amendment to allow somebody to contest for a 3rd time. And he's the man who limited it. And his predecessor was elected 4 times, 3 full terms he served, and in the 4th term, 1 year he served. He stopped it.
Wow.
He stopped America being from the danger of being getting a dictator to take over the per term. You know, in USSR, Putin was there for how many years already? And he's the president for life.
Right.
No, not in America. America never allows that because of Truman.
Did Putin just recently change their term of presidency to like 32 years? I mean, something really almost like president to life just recently within the last six months to a year. Did he change their terms? I'm trying to when his reelection came around? Because I could have sworn I heard that
During the end of Obama term, they floated an idea to make him a president for a 3rd term and change the law. And I did not gain support, and it fizzled out to the best of my knowledge. I don't think the term of presidents and the tenure of president has changed in America. To the best of my knowledge, you know, if something happened, I did not know, I do not know, but during the end of Obama term, this proposal came up, but it did not gain momentum, to the best of my knowledge.
Oh, okay. There's another piece that I really like here. Here it says, we're talking about Truman and your opinion, the greatest statesman of all time, of the entire world. There's an interesting piece that you have here. I was trying to find it. It's when Truman fired MacArthur. He took a lot of heat fired MacArthur, if I remember right. But it says here, you're saying Truman did not look for the benefit, for his benefit, but that of the nation. He did not look for his benefit, but that of the nation. When he was perhaps the boldest man in terms of taking decision, he did not look for his benefit, but that of the nation. When he fired General MacArthur, he ensured that the office of the President of the United States of America cannot and will not be disrespected regardless of who occupies the office and whosoever mighty or popular that person may be. No other person showed that kind of commitment for the honor of the office or the boldness for the action than he was.
Who else besides him can take such an unpopular decision like that? Yeah, so when he did fire MacArthur, he got into a lot of didn't his popularity went down for a while? Then people did not, after all, General MacArthur was a hero. What's your opinion on that after he fired MacArthur, General MacArthur?
Oh, my God, he took a heavy beating in popularity, Bob. You know, why I wrote that MacArthur disrespected the office of the president of USA. After the Japan was surrendered and Truman went to Japan, okay, to formally take the surrender. There was a protocol discussion between MacArthur and Truman. And the protocol, they said, the MacArthur will come to the stairs from the aeroplane and receive him at the bottom of the staircase of the aeroplane. And MacArthur refused. He said, let Truman walk to the terminal. I will receive him in the terminal. And it has been a nightmare for the protocol officers how to convince these two people. President of United States of America is coming. Truman is not only the President of United States of America, he is the Commander-in-Chief of the Armed Forces. And MacArthur is a general, and his boss is Truman. He has to receive him at the bottom of the staircase. He refused. And finally, you know what happened, how it was resolved. This has come in Reader's Digest. I am not talking of my own gossip. This was in Reader's Digest sometime back in the 80s. Mm-hmm. At the same time, when Truman appears on the top of the staircase after the door is opened, and MacArthur will stand at the outside the gate of the terminal, and both start walking towards each other, and MacArthur will receive wherever he meets Truman on the way on the red carpet. See, the insult he has caused to the President of the United States. And Truman let it pass, and as soon as he came back to USA, the first action he took was to fire MacArthur. The movie Truman, produced by HBO, showed this scene. His mother-in-law, his own mother-in-law, his wife's mother, criticized Truman on his face. MacArthur is a war hero. What guts you have to fire him?
Mm-hmm.
And his wife answers her mother. Mother, he is the president of United States. He can fire anybody. And Truman tells her, see, MacArthur can insult Truman the man, but MacArthur cannot insult the president of United States of America.
Very interesting.
This is there in that movie. Yes. I may be useless. But I am still, but the President of United States, that badge is on me, and he cannot insert that badge, that chair, that position.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know,
very.
In the same Democratic Party, when Truman said nobody in the world can insert the President of United States of America, photographs circulated wherein Obama was bending and bowing to the King of Saudi Arabia. That was the difference between two Democratic presidents. A President Truman, who said the President of POTUS, President of the United States of America, is the supreme being in the world. He will bow to none, and everybody has to bow to him.
You know, that goes back to, and help me out, Morale, because, again, you know, I was a bad student in school. You know, you were studying, you got DAs, I mean, you were the guy. I was busy with the mirrors on my shoes looking under chicks' dresses. But anyway, I think I learned something. In the Roman Empire, when the Romans walked the earth, They were almost, as you're putting Harriet Truman and how Harriet Truman believed the office of the President of the United States, you do not kill a Roman soldier. If you did, you would have the whole Roman army coming after you, meaning that they were untouchable. They were almost like gods. Correct me if I was wrong.
Yes.
Do you think that Truman had the same idea with the American soldier, meaning, or America? You don't mess with America. If you mess with America, we will bring hell to you. We are untouchable. We are like American gods. Do you think Truman felt that way toward the nation of America and to a lot of European, America? In your mind, was it similar? I don't know if you followed me on that, but you think it was similar?
Yeah, I follow you. I follow you very well. I follow you very well, Brian. But, he did not go that far because he allowed Soviet Russia to survive. He did not declare a war on Soviet Russia immediately because Russia messed with America. He only started the Cold War and left it at that. But, Romans are not as humane as Truman was. Here is Truman who went and respected the Europe and Japan. Romans, when they brought hell, they left the hell. Truman was not like that. He started the doctrine of reconstruction. First time in history, he reconstructed Europe. He reconstructed Japan, all the countries that were affected by America. America left as friends. Germans looked up at America as friends, even though entire Germany was bombed out by America. Japan, which is began the attack on Pearl Harbor and brought America into the war, Japan felt America as friends. And the entire Europe, France, Italy, even Italians feared America as a friend. He never said he's a god. He was a real god. He showed. He helped, he punished. A God really helps, is merciful, and also punishes when we do wrong. And Truman did help, showed mercy on them. He took American dollars to reconstruct the infrastructure in Germany, Japan, Italy, and all those countries. And Romans did not do that. They created hell, they caused hell, they brought hell and left them. Panting. No, Truman did not do that. Truman gave the hand after beating the hell out of people. He took the hand, made them stand on their legs, gave them water and tonics and medicines, and brought them back to health. He nurtured back to health. So Truman never said, "I am like God." Truman was God.
But he had, I can put it as great honor. But I'm talking to my good friend who makes me look smart, my good friend Morale. And he came up with this document and titled The Greatest Statesman of All Time of the Entire World in His 70 Years. And we're talking about it, and it's Harry Truman. There are some people, America has changed, Morale. Some people believe that we should not be the global policemen of the world, but Truman thought we should be. Is that correct?
At the time, time changes, Brian. With the time, people become different. In 1948, Germany, Japan, and Italy having their armies was not good. But in 2020, 21st century, they have to protect themselves. There is a change. At that time, if America was not the global policeman, Russia would have gobbled up the entire Europe and Asia. The British and French and Italian empires would have been replaced by Russian Empire. And after that, after the break of USSR in 1990, the aspirations, empire-building aspirations of Russia are put to rest. They are no more doing that. And the global policing was not required from 1990. But come 2020, The necessity has raised its head again. This time, the China is raising its head to build an empire. You know, if you overlook that, if America overlooks that, they will be building an empire in 10, 15 years or maybe 20 years. China will be another empire, and it is a danger to the world. If democracy was encouraged, Truman. If empire building was discouraged and fought, Truman. And at that time, global policing was required. After 1990, there was no need. And Germany and Japan and Italy, they were asked to build their armies, and they are building their armies. Now, but 2020, the situation again changed. China under Xi Jinping is having aspirations of empire. They are taking over Pakistan. They are taking over Sri Lanka. They are taking over the islands near Japan, and they are claiming China Sea is ours. Nobody enters that.
Is that your phone?
No, it doesn't matter.
Okay.
No problem, no problem. Yeah.
Oh, no, it's okay. So was it true I heard stories that Truman was a great dancer?
I don't know.
I'm only joking. I'm joking. He was in a wheelchair.
Yeah,
it was just
okay.
A little joke to throw you off. It was just a little joke. you know I'm going to be silly. You know I'm going to be silly during this. This is so interesting. And this goes into, I want to put the trans, you know, goes into, do you think America, after Truman, Eisenhower, in your opinion, was Eisenhower a good president, or you think Eisenhower rolled off the coattails of Truman, just, you know, in that bast of glory? What's your opinion about Eisenhower?
Eisenhower, you know, in the world, Bob, Brian, there are some people, they are popular. They are popular not because they did something, but they have that kind of personality which makes them popular and make them sit on the throne, like kings of yesteryear. Eisenhower was a general. He was the supreme commander of Allied forces in the European theater during the Second World War. And he had his critics, especially in Montgomery, General Montgomery of Britain, who felt that he should have had the command. And another hero, a war hero, General Patton, General Patton. A movie was made on General Patton. A movie was not made on Eisenhower so far. A movie was made on Harry Truman. A movie was not made on Eisenhower. And Patton was also put down by... And because Eisenhower did things which are popular, which have the least resistance and the easy way out. Like, you know, the water finds the lowest gradient to flow. It does not go for opposition. And in that manner, he fought the Second World War. At the end of the Second World War, he gave Berlin and Hitler to Russians. The victory was theirs. Berlin was occupied, and the Second World War in the European theater was ended, not by America, but by Russia. And Russia was in the death throes in 1941 December when Hitler's guns were firing on the outskirts of Moscow. It was with American assistance that Russia came back into the war.
And you know, that's very interesting that you said it, because Russia did, and they didn't get the credit, because Russia did, and correct me if I'm wrong, because I'm just trying to remember my history. The mistake that Hitler did was he was fighting at too many fronts. Second of all, he didn't really predict the weather, and he did not give his troops enough comfort in the wintertime, and a lot of his, we're talking Hitler, a lot of troops froze to death and blah, 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 blah. But, yeah, you're right. You would give the Russians more of a credit for ending World War II than you would give the Americans, Morali?
No, actually, the Second World War, in 1941, April, Hitler invaded Russia. And in 6 months' time, he was just 30 miles from the Kremlin, firing his guns, 1941. 6 months, and Russia just president sent SOS to USA, save me, and the USA sent tanks from Alaska to Russia, Siberia, and all that. They brought the tanks, and in 6 months they did not offer any resistance to the Germans. German just walked like cakewalk into Russia. And when America started supplying the arms and the ammunition to Russia, they started fighting. And what took Hitler 6 months to traverse, it took 4 years for Russia to come to the River Elbe in Germany. And it was all with the assistance of America. America sent factories for building tanks and for building other things. And with that they came, and because if you read the novels, the Great Battle and other things by Rand Collins and others, they wrote that suddenly in the Second World War, the army strategy, the fighting strategy was to occupy the industrial areas and not head for Berlin. Patton was ready to go to Berlin and occupy it before Russia could come. But the course was changed, and Russia was allowed to take Berlin. Russia took the Berlin, and once the Germans surrendered to Russia, the war stopped. Who surrendered? Germany to whom? Germany surrendered to Russia, not to America. Yes.
Very interesting. Yes. We don't read that in our history books. In our history book was General Patton, baby, and MacArthur, the heroes of the war, and they surrendered to us, not to the Russians. And I mean, it's very interesting there, Morali.
They surrendered to Russia.
Yeah. Okay. Well, we're almost at the end of our interview. Yes, go ahead.
And the four powers gathered in Berlin to finally formally accept the surrender. But the white flag was shown to the Russian general, Marshal Zhukov. Marshal Zhukov took the surrender of Germany, and then all of the four powers came to Berlin and took over the surrender of Germany. And taking over Germany, from that time, Truman ensured that they have a footstep in Berlin and healthy country. So that is how the history, Brian.
This time I'm paying attention to it, and I love history.
Thank you.
We go from the best, in your opinion, in your humble opinion, because you finished the piece, and I love how you finished the piece with to the greatest statesman of all time for the entire world. Here are my humble salutations. You are a very humble man, but you're a genius. I mean, if I had your brain, I'd be bragging all over. We go from the greatest president of the world to the worst president of the world. In your opinion, do you have an opinion how the decline of America, as far as decline of American leadership, is or was, and who would you, in your opinion, believe was the worst president in the United States, and maybe don't have any honor or just plain didn't really give a fuck?
Not really. I don't attribute it to a president, Brian, but you know, the first president who began outsourcing to China and led to the fall of quality of products in the USA are two people, Henry Kissinger and Richard Nixon. These two people began the outsourcing of manufacturing to China, and which led to the complete closure of manufacturing facilities in USA and gradually lost employment. You know, sometime back I happened to meet one of the industry development organization, governmental organization in New York with one of my friends, and he wanted to start some kind of company. He said in India, in America, the only thing you can start is either a restaurant or a Walmart type of mall. Nothing, no manufacturing can be done here. And because of, in my humble opinion, Richard Nixon and Henry Kissinger, who opened the doors. Until that time, China was not formally recognized by USA, and these two recognized China and then shifted manufacturing. Now that, you know, China, if China stops supplying to USA, all the stores will be empty tomorrow of all the goods.
Right.
And that's a bad situation. I think China, America will recover from that. Whoever president comes, I'm sure they will begin shifting manufacturing back to America. And those two people I credit for the downfall.
Very wise. The greatest statesman of all time, of the entire world in your 70 years of life, Harry Truman. Do you have any, as of now we're bringing it up to this date, and you know I'm going to ask you this. Have you seen anything like this before, how Americans are acting towards each other, almost like civil war, because of a leader of the United States? I'm going to go with Trump. And have you ever seen a president who personally attacked the American citizens personally if they did not honor him correctly? Have you ever seen any of this thing in your lifetime, how Donald Trump is acting towards his own American citizens?
Brian, you know, my knowledge of American presidents is very, very, very limited. My politics is very, very, you know, not there. I'm a nonentity and novice in politics and how the people acted. I do not know, really. I do not know even President Trump or President Washington or President Obama or anybody, President Clinton.
Well,
only those highlights that come into the world that I know.
Sure.
So I am not sure and I cannot comment. I am not qualified to pass that comment.
Oh, yes, you are. You're American. Listen, you're qualified to comment on, you know, we honor President Trump, and we gave him a nickname, Dumbfuck. That's our word of saying you're a good guy. Yeah. Mr. Morale, it's always been a pleasure, and it always is a pleasure. Have you sent this document to the newspapers or to historians? Or because it should be, I think it's brilliant, by the way. And people should be able to read this. Have you sent it anywhere so people can read the whole document? Because how you laid it off, how you laid it out, and how you went into details, it's very interesting. I think it's brilliant. What are you going to do with it now?
I see, Bob, you know, Brian, you know, the publishing world, unless you know somebody, nobody will look at this document. The people in the publishing world are high and mighty, and they don't condescend to take my call if I call them, and I do not know which number to call and whom to call. If I send it to the editor, I think there will be a pile of such documents waiting for his attention, and they never look at it. So I know, and I think it deserves publication, but I do not know anybody. If you feel like sending it, please send it. I don't know where to put it up. I am compiling all my essays into some book. I think I will include this in that, and I'm circulating it to my friends like you. Say, ask them their opinions. That's what I have been doing. If it deserves publication in a big name like New York Times or Washington Post on the front page, or at least on the op-ed page. But, you know, I don't know anybody to make him look at this document.
Well, I do have a
If somebody looks at this document, I'd like to definitely send it and get it published.
Okay, I do have a news blog. I could publish it in my news blog, give you the credit, and promote it everywhere, and hit those people. Maybe they'll pick it up, because I think it's brilliant if you allow me to do that. Because I think
please,
people
please
should...
Go ahead, man. Please go ahead. Please go ahead. You have my permission.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. And I will, I'm so proud that you even asked me to read it. I'm being really serious. It was, I think it's brilliant. I really do. Absolutely brilliant. That's the end of our interview. It goes by so fast with you. It's like you and I dance, and then the song's over. How quick is that?
Thank you. Thank you, Brian. Thanks. It's my pleasure. It is always a pleasure to be with you on the show. And this time also, I'm very, very happy. And thank you very much for giving me this opportunity to be with your audience. Have a great day, Brian, and wish you success.
Well, thank you. Thank you. I'm honored. And you have a great day, too. And I'm going to get to work on publishing that in my blog and send it out to people who should be reading it. Everybody, the great Morali Shumatori. Did I say it right? Shumatori?
Yes, yes, Brian. Correct.
Yes, I did. All right. Thank you, sir. And we'll be right back when we were talking about the greatest president in the world. We're going to talk about, Donald Trump. All right.
Goodbye.
We'll be right back after this. Thank you, Morali. Thank you, sir.
Have a great day. Thank you, Bob.
You too. Have a great day. And I know this number. Hello, sweetheart. Heard that lovely voice of yours, and thank you for waiting. Is this Miss Lisa?
Hey.
How are you? Thank you for holding. What did you think? Isn't Morali pretty great? Isn't the guy pretty cool?
Yeah, I picked up bits and pieces.